Thank you for having me. You can hear me okay, correct?
Yes, we can.
Wonderful. And here it is, the presentation. Again, really excited to be here because not only can I share with you the amazing and important work United Way is doing, but obviously collectively as a nonprofit and social sector, this has been a struggle. This addressing all the community needs and what we can do and what needs to be done. So the need is great, and we're here to respond. So we can move forward. I just wanted to give a quick update on our COVID-19 response for those of you who may not be familiar with it. So we raised and disseminated funds from March 2020 to July 2020. That fund has now closed, but we were able to raise and disseminate rapidly over $285,000. The funding, as you can kind of see laid out there, went to food and basic needs was our top area of need, with over $100,000 being donated into that area in our community. And then it goes on from housing, education, housing and shelter, mental health, general resource needs, cleanliness products. There was over $22,000 that was utilized from different area nonprofits for cleanliness. And the relief fund really did provide the immediate support for the nonprofit sector while they met needs for various neighbors in need, clients, folks that they serve. 54 grants were awarded, 31 local agencies, and it really then became an innovative partnership with the Sheboygan Service Club. So this was not just a United Way effort. This was the Sheboygan Service Club stepping up and wanting to raise funds and give back, as well as the United Way of Sheboygan County board members combining to make this happen. So other responses we had, if you click forward, we had obviously a COVID-19 nonprofit response network. 50 plus agencies have participated. We get anywhere from 20 to 50 agencies on a call. We have convened these conversations. It was around 15 weeks straight. We were meeting weekly on Tuesdays. And more than just meeting, we were being good stewards of our donor dollars. We were trying to collaborate in ways that were maybe not thought of prior. Obviously, that's what a pandemic does. It really challenges us to think outside the box and what can we do as a community to come together. So some amazing outcomes occurred because of these conversations and because of working together. We had a general community resources page, which is still live, still active, and you can also get to it by SheboyganCountyStrong.com. which was supported also by our corporate partners at Kohler. So this resource page was another way in which to share out information that the city was sharing, that schools were sharing. 2-1-1 is another great resource. And then, of course, we were supporting our volunteer center network. And then came civil unrest, right? And then DEI, diversity, equity, and inclusion became one of our needs to respond to also as a social sector. So United Way, along with a number of other social sector leaders, have formed a smaller committee working with the Sheboygan Diversity, Equity, Inclusion, and Belonging Initiative, and we are moving our way through that because of the utmost importance for how that impacts equity in our community, and what does that mean? So again, speaking to the volunteer center, speaking to all the good that's happening, someone on the Common Council might say, well, why is this important right now? Obviously, employers need to know this and hear this as well. Quality of life, talent acquisition, retention, bringing people into the county, into the city to stay, robust volunteerism and philanthropic giving is really critical to the way in which we present our community and live our lives. So always excited to share more information on that if anyone wants information there. If we move on to the next slide, just a little overview quick of the campaign kickoff and Day of Caring. We really wanted to promote virtual volunteer opportunities for obvious reasons, safety and health and concerns. There are a number of volunteer opportunities that have continued through this pandemic that really are essential workers coming together. So we did have a number of in-person volunteer opportunities. We had an Acts of Kindness challenge. Our newsletter just went out tonight. So if you're curious about watching any of the videos that occurred, any of our presentations I'll talk about, all of the links are there. It's all on our website. And a great quote that was shared in our recent website from Abraham Joshua Henschel, an American Polish rabbi, once said, "When I was young, I admired clever people. Now that I am old, I admire kind people." And so we really wanted to push kindness because we know we're very polarized as, you know, a nation, a community. How can we come together and how can we really unite? Because that's what United Way is here for. So we have been really trying to think outside the box to support our community on those levels. We had donation drives that were hugely successful, not just through our community impact initiatives, but other agencies in the community that we help support. And again, all of this is important because we are facing really a mountain of what's coming in the next number of months, donor fatigue. How can we make sure our social sector remains, that the foundation remains strong to service and continue to support all the people we do collectively? So if we highlight the next slide, it really speaks to how we've also tried to incorporate community education. So I'm here just quickly to have my 12 minutes to talk to you all about all the things happening. But again, a conversation on Alice was had. We have all that information. If you have more interest in learning more about that specifically, one, you can watch that event. We can present another time. Alice, again, is Asset Limited Income Constrained Employed. It's an acronym that speaks to those that live above the federal poverty level, but below the basic cost of living. So in our community in Sheboygan County, the latest data that just came out was from 2018. And what's a little frightening is that we know more individuals have fallen into poverty because of the pandemic and therefore fallen into the ALICE level. So maybe current ALICE families now would be considered poverty. We're watching closely, obviously, the free and reduced lunch rates in our community and trying to really get a heartbeat for how this pandemic has impacted our those most vulnerable. Financially and health equity, racial equity, all of those things. So again, this report helps community members, donors, nonprofits, and businesses understand the population in Sheboygan County and what we can do for housing, what we can do for job security, how we can come and work together and really figure out what is living wages and how can we support our employers. And it's not a this and us, it's not political. It is really about just getting the information out there and making sure that you're all aware there are plenty of programs that do respond and support ALICE families as well. So all of that information in our latest newsletter on our website. We also had a conversation on food stability. This continues to be of utmost concern. And we are so grateful to partner with and have amazing organizations like Sheboygan County Food Bank, Meals on Wheels. Sheboygan Area School District also spoke at this panel on food stability. And so understanding again the needs for those basic needs and what that means to be hungry and how that's on any given day, 11,000 people are struggling with food in Sheboygan County, that we, what we can do as a community to come together to address that. So lots of issues to handle and lots of ways in which we are trying to get those words out and raise funds for that. So if we move on, our community impact initiatives, just a quick overview so you understand some of the other work United Way is doing. CPC, again, stands for Sheboygan County Community Partnership for Children. So this is not just Sheboygan County United Way as an agency. It is also the Family Resource Center. It is also the Early Learning Center. It is also Family Connections. It's a number of early care and education agencies coming together. It's a cradle to career initiative. Some of the programs they provide, welcome baby visits. So every first time mom in Sheboygan County gets a visit at the hospital. Also the dads, right? But the moms are, you know, usually there. And what that means is resource sharing, understanding if they have other areas of challenges that we could support as a community and how to direct families to those resources. It's about investing early so we then can save funding further down the line, whether that means in our judicial systems, and where that mental health funding, all of those things, if we can invest early, it makes a difference. So they also do developmental screens, parent cafes. They have been working really throughout this entire pandemic, virtually pivoting like all of us, PATH is another Community Impact Initiative. Just a brief update for you all. That stands for Providing Access to Healing. And what that is it is putting therapists in the schools. So licensed therapists will go to the schools, now some virtual, right? Chippewa Area School District had to make that tough decision. But we've been able to do remote or telehealth therapy. We served last year in a given school week throughout Sheboygan County, over 455 therapy sessions were occurring. 455 in 1 week. So all county, all public school districts in the county are involved in this. We're hoping to expand it. We need support to do this. And again, this is a very preventative thing. We know we're all experiencing collective trauma right now as a community, as a nation, as a world. That's what this pandemic really has shown us. And addressing mental health needs more important than ever. So total therapy sessions we were able to provide last year, 22,295. So that's been quite incredible. Our partners there are Lakeshore Community Healthcare, and also Ozaki Community Therapies. So again, working with all the schools. And then of course, I mentioned our volunteer center a little, trying to think outside the box and the importance of understanding how we can make that connection. So if we move along, just some quick brief outputs that team wanted to share. 14,000 youth participated in programs. This is last year. 589 parents received parenting education. We had over 1,000 welcome baby visits in person last year. We've just done 200 in the last couple months. And so then those have now gone virtual. So again, trying to pivot. Lots going on. As you see, that there was 28,100 nights of shelter provided to our community. Collectively, 5,300 people received budget counseling. A lot of important information happening in our community. And it's only because of this collective nature to come together. Our partner agencies this year are listed here. Obviously, I can give anyone this PowerPoint, or it would be a part of the minutes, I imagine, access to it for the Common Council tonight. But we have a number of partner agencies. And again, you know, when people ask, who are United Way's clients? What do we do? Well, not only do we have the direct service of PATH and the students in the mental health program, not only do we have the direct service of parents in CPC, Community Partnership for Children, but we also see our entire sector, our social sector, and those nonprofits as our clients. How can we support them? So we list the partner agencies. They receive financial funding from a community action team that really objectively looks at financial requests, and then we use community needs, and there's a whole system there. But further than that, we've really reached out to all the nonprofits to kind of find that heartbeat for what's going on. So then this last slide, just wanted to speak to some of the needs we're still seeing happening. So obviously, there's a ton of needs related to youth, mentoring youth. Housing has been an issue. Highly mobile or just affordable housing continues to be an issue. I know the city's doing lots of things on that, so we're really grateful for that. Employment, you know, right now we're working with consumer credit counselors who are trying to reinvigorate the job seekers network that really started in 2008 when we were in the Great Recession, and how can we engage those who need a job and all these great corporate partners who have jobs. So what's happening? Where's the disconnect? How can we reach out? Trying to convene those conversations, push that forward. Again, food security and mental health I mentioned tonight. Also just domestic violence and safety. Huge concerns. Not everybody is safer at home when we're safer at home. So some of the organizations we probably support are able to help address those in need, in dire need, really, in this sort of situation. Not listed, but also I mentioned prior was DEI, diversity, equity, inclusion, and just really equity. So United Way has been here. We've been here in this community because of people like you on the screen for 89 years, 90 years next year. And what we've been able to do in those 89 years is address equity. That is who we are, whether that be socioeconomic equity, health equity, racial equity, all of those inequities that individuals face, and how can we really come together to solve complex problems in our community. So it is bleak. It is. It's not hopeless, though. There's certainly in our community are fears of donor fatigue occurring. loss of revenue from direct service in-person programming occurring amongst all our nonprofit friends and colleagues, loss of fundraising, special event revenue. We're, again, facing an incredible hill to climb up, but we are up for the challenge. I hope you are up to join us in any way you can in accepting and jumping in for more education on how we can support our community, in donating if you can, in giving back time, talents, treasures, whatever that looks like to you. The sector needs it, we need it, and we're happy to have this little platform to share that message. So that was a lot. as I say what I need to say in my 10 minutes, right? Really want to just share again that if there's any way in which you think you could utilize more information, have us help be that leader that we see that we are and have been for all of these years in this community, please don't hesitate to reach out and let us know. My information is all there. My team's information is all there. There's a number of different resources. 211 is a great one. Just want to continue to say United Way is here. We're not going anywhere. We're here because of you. And the need is greater than ever. So anything the city can do in regards to supporting the sector, as I know you have with different unique funding opportunities, I think it's really relevant to consider the impact those will have, even though the time and energy to go through those routes. So,
Kate, thank you so much for that great presentation on the activities in United Way, and we look forward to kicking off our campaign shortly within our employee group. So thank you very much.